All right, step five in our guide for how to become a DJ is getting DJ hardware. Now, while it's possible to get started using only your laptop, you're eventually going to want a little bit more control. So, it's time to look into some hardware. But how do you even know where to aim? Well, let's talk a little bit about the different types of DJ setups that exist. There's the DJ controller option, which is where you connect an all-in-one device to your laptop in order to control DJ software. Then there's the CDJ and mixer setup, where you use CDJs and other standalone media players and a hardware mixer, no laptop required. There's of course the beloved vinyl setup, where you use turntables and a mixer to play vinyl records the old-fashioned way. And then there are hybrid versions of these setups. For example, DBS or timecode setups let you control digital music on a laptop using real records. Now, if you're just getting started and you're looking to buy your first piece of hardware, I highly recommend going the route of the DJ controller. Now, without a doubt, this is the most sensible way to get started. A modern all-in-one DJ controller contains everything that you need to mix and record music, well, except for a laptop. And options range anywhere from less than $100 to over 3 grand, so you can really scale it to your available budget. Now, CDJ setups are awesome, don't get me wrong. As the so-called industry standard, CDJs can be found in nightclubs, festivals, and arenas all across the world. They were originally designed to play music from compact discs, but modern CDJs and XDJs and other players play digital music stored on USB drives. Now, the players are plugged into a hardware DJ mixer. Pioneer CDJs, combined with their DJM mixers, provide a shared platform for DJs, and many venues already have them, and they're kind of the expected standard for any large show. CDJs tend to be more expensive controller counterparts, but they do offer a level of separation from that laptop. And as for vinyl, well, it's quite a commitment. I mean, records are harder to mix than any of the other listed options. Vinyl is also the most expensive format to buy music on, and in many ways, I mean, it's more limiting than a digital setup. So why would anyone want to go this route? Well, for a lot of people, mixing records is simply fun. I mean, many DJs love that tactile feel of moving the physical record, and many people love watching a real DJ playing real records. And it's also the best route for the pure scratch DJ. Now, this isn't going to be the route for everyone, of course, but for many people, it's the only way. Now, of course, you're welcome to mix, match, and hybridize these setups any way that you see fit. I often use a timecode setup myself, these turntables in combination with a digital DJ controller. I love the feel of mixing records, but I also love the functionality that I gain from software, such as perfect loops, four-deck mixing, and recording. And I love being able to have my entire digital music collection with me wherever I go. So many people feel that using a timecode setup can give you the best of all worlds, but again, by far the most sensible and scalable way to get started is by investing in a good DJ controller that fits your budget. "But David," you cry, "there are so many options. How will I ever know what DJ controller is right for me? If only you had a link for that." Well, fear not, my friends. As you may have guessed, I've put together the perfect resource for just such an occasion. Just head on over to passionatedj.com/controllers and you'll find the controller compendium. Now, that's just one big mega guide, kind of like this one, that compares the top DJ controllers so that you can feel confident before you spend your hard-earned money on them. Now, I give it a major update pretty much every year, and since 2014, it's helped thousands of DJs just like you decide which is the best DJ controller for them. So, once again, that's the controller compendium, passionatedj.com/controllers. All right, so we're over halfway through our journey towards becoming a DJ. We've talked about the different kinds of DJs and different reasons to become one. We've discussed the different skills that DJs use in their sets. We've explored some DJ software, maybe picked a platform that we like, and now we've chosen some basic DJ hardware, probably a budget-friendly controller of some kind. So now it's time to start mixing and recording to see what we really sound like.